Hey everybody, it's me, James. I am so happy because today I found my friends there after the burial. After the burial released a new song technically yesterday, but I don't have SiriusXM, so I had to wait until today to take a look at it. Listening to new After the Burial is kind of like putting on your favorite jacket for the first time this year, which is very fitting because in the state of Minnesota where I and this band are from, it is still magnificent. It's like somehow it's snowing. Again, still snowing. So we're going to be taking a look at the new After the Burial song, Nothing Gold. Be sure to leave a comment down below. What do you think of this new song? And don't forget to subscribe and join the vinyl cult.
After the Burial, Nothing Gold.
Yes. You know, okay, so I say, like, it's like putting on your favorite jacket because it is, like, there are some bands that just every album reinvent themselves. After the Burial certainly innovate, but that, like, it's just, like, they sound like themselves. Like, they might as well be a genre. That, like, dual guitar sound that they've kept throughout all these years, even though they tragically lost their guitarist. It's just always so spot on, and it's so nice to hear. After last week's video, I so needed just like something awesome, as I'm sure you guys did too. I bet I could play this part on guitar. They always have like the best breakdowns. I want to hear that again. That is too fun. One thing that I always appreciate about this band is like they are obviously in like the djent, like progressive metal, like category. I feel like sometimes in that music, it's really easy. It's easy to lose the beat, especially if you're like not super into that music or don't know how to like get the rhythm when there's like a lot of like like polyrhythms going on. But After the Burial always keeps that bus driving forward, I guess is the best way to put it. There's always forward momentum and it's easy to follow. And not because it's not as like technical or complex as other artists, but because they write things that are so groovy and so heavy too. Like they definitely don't skimp on that. They're very good at making stuff accessible, technical, and just fun. Also, we're going to go back here just a little bit. Another thing that I really like about the name of the guitarist is escaping me, but the fact that he can bring melody in the low end, because they play with like 8-string, 9-string guitars. And I feel like a lot of times when like metal bands use that, it's just like deep chugs, but there's not there, it's not as melody focused, and he really takes care to like have like melodic riffs in that low register. Damn. All right. I couldn't be happier with that. That chorus, I love a good strong chorus, and Nothing Gold really, I mean, that chorus, that like the whole song, it's chef's kiss. Maybe I'm just prejudiced because they are hometown boys, man. That song, it was killer. I loved that. That was like exactly what I needed to round out the week. That gets me excited for like even more to come. I know there's another song out. What is it? Death Keeps Us From Living, out right now. At this moment, I don't know if they've released a like an announcement for a new album. I assume that'll be coming at some point, unless they're doing an EP right now. But either way, keep it coming. I want more. So be sure to comment down below. What did you think of this song? Go ahead and leave me a like if you feel so inclined. And don't forget to subscribe and join the Vinyl Cult. And I'll see you next time.